my kid's birthday.
Bye, Diane.
So long, Sophie.
Bye, Diane.
What are you doing here? You're supposed to be in Hoffman's office in 10 minutes.
The conference call went on forever. If you find me 301, I swear I'll give you my firstborn.
Well, thanks. I've met your firstborn. Here, why don't you try 300, specific intent? 301 is general.
300, that makes sense. I'll give it some thought.
Yeah, you got about 35 seconds. Then I suggest you move your ass, sir.
You could get your law degree, I'd hire you like that.
You'd have to put me through college first. I'd cost you a bundle. Now get out of here. Okay, we're gonna have to make this fast. It's Sean's birthday, and I got a zillion things to do. Can't let a little thing like a reception for the governor get in the way of picking up my son's cake, etc., etc. Okay, what have we heard from the Grand?
The International Ballroom holds 350.
That's good, but check with the Regency and see if they can match the Grand's price per person. And not with rubber chicken, either. Music?
I have a call into the union.
I was thinking maybe classical. What do you think?
That's great.
Press release, I'll handle that myself. You want to call the governor's office and tell them that?
Okay.
Okay, that does it.
I'm so glad they asked you to introduce the governor. You know, the partners are pushing for you.
Well, that's just because I'm female. They're so 1960s around here. They don't have any lady partners, as they like to call them. Okay, see you later.
Okay, have fun. Bye.
Thanks.
Sorry, ma'am, but you can't stop here.
Sorry, where am I?
Well, where do you need to get to?
Could you give me some suggestions?
Giffordsville, Porter City?
Porter City, yes.
Okay.
Porter City.
Okay, which side? East side? West side?
Where there are houses?
Brylin, maybe?
Yes, Brylin.
Okay, what you do is you go straight.
Wait a second. Would you just wait a second?
Sure.
No, I just want
to
write this down. Yes?
Go straight. Take the first right.
Right.
You'll get to an overpass.
An overpass.
Go over the overpass.
Yeah.
And then when you get to Hazlitt Avenue.
Hazlitt.
Just look to your right, and you'll see Brylin.
Thank you.
Okay?
Thank you.
Gonna be okay?
I think so.
Great.
Thank you.
Of course I did.
What'd you do that for?
Because those hotshot lawyers think they own you, Diane. You were supposed to have the afternoon off, remember? Where have you been? It's 4:30, for God's sake.
Why are you giving me the third degree, Jack?
Because I was worried.
I'm sorry.
Well, you could have at least called.
I know, I'm sorry.
You should be.
When did the kids get here?
A couple hours ago. Did you leave the cake in the car?
Oh, my gosh.
Don't tell me you forgot again. You forgot again, didn't you? What's wrong with you, Diane? You used to be like an elephant.
I'm just gonna forget I heard that one.
I guess I should go pick it up now, huh?
Would you? It's paid for. And the cold cuts. The market's just a few doors down.
You didn't even pick up the food for the party? Diane, there are 18 people coming over here in a few hours. I don't know what you expected them to eat.
I'm sorry.
Crib in a minute. Hey, it's your grandma. What you looking for?
Grandma's picture? You know, the one you said I could have for the mommy and me group? It's the graduation one, I think. You remember? We're doing that generational thing?
Oh, yes, yes, I was gonna show you, that's right. Now, where did I put that?
Actually, you know what? Don't worry about it.
No, I put it in here. I'm sure.
Mom, don't worry about it, okay? I left work early to help you set up, so let's get started.
I'm sorry, sweetheart, I'm sorry.
I just wish you'd called. You know, it's like trying to make conversation with Dad for 2 hours. It's either total silence or Vietnam.
Give him a break, sweetheart. It's been a long week.
Yeah.
I hope that's your husband. We need help with the drinks.
Okay. What? What do you need?
Oh, I have glasses, ice.
Okay.
And stuff.
Will you watch him?
Yes, sure.
Where is that birthday boy? For he's the jolly good fellow. For he's the jolly good fellow. For he's the jolly good fellow. Nobody can deny.
There you go, kid. I've been working all day on this, haven't I, Tracy?
Oh, yeah, slaved for hours over those roses. Make a wish, doofus.
I already did.
Okay, stand back. One more time.
And it came true. She said yes. Everybody, you are all the people that we love most in this world, and we know about being stupid and everything, but we wanted you to be the first to know. We got engaged, baby!
You can't do this! You're supposed to be my bratty little brother! Wow!
Oh my goodness. No, I didn't.
Oh, great. Oh, my.
We have to open the champagne. Can I use the camera?
I just got one more shot, love.
Okay, go on. Give me a hug.
I can't believe it.
Now, no getting married till after grad school.
I'll get
some more.
Diane! Mom!
I'm okay.
Are you all right?
I'm okay. I'm okay.
You're supposed to put one foot in front of the other one, babe.
You're all hard.
What did you trip on?
I'm fine. I'm a klutz. Stop looking at me. I'm okay. I'm really fine. Go on now, stop. I'm fine.
You really shaken up? You fell hard.
Well, I just slipped, that's all.
No, you didn't. I saw it. You didn't slip. You didn't trip either.
I know, Paul, something's wrong.
Excuse me, you got some more film?
Yeah, I think in the top, right there in the top one. So how's it feel, Pop?
Nah, he's too young. What you getting engaged for?
You remember love?
I do. A lot of things passed for it when I was that age.
You better not be talking about me, Maureen, because I remember you camping out on my doorstep night after night, begging me to marry you.
It's not the way I remember it.
You just wore me down.
You were crazy, Mommy. Wasn't she, Paul?
I was crazy anyway.
Leave me out of this. I'll catch up with you later.
Now, what's up, kid? You told her something was wrong. What is it?
Hey, my baby's engaged.
Yeah, I heard. His timing stinks, if you ask me. She's already lost 2 years of college because of the accident. And between us, I hope she's not pregnant because they got absolutely nothing.
For that matter, neither did we. And that turned out all right, didn't it?
You tell me.
I asked you first.
Mostly. You sure you're all right?
Mostly.
Well, the party's downstairs. You coming?
Yeah, I'll be there in just a couple minutes.
Here's looking at you, kid.
Mom? What are you doing? There's a party going on downstairs.
I found it.
On what?
Grandma's picture.
Mom, I didn't mean for it to be such a big deal.
Oh, no, I've got it right here. Look, I found it.
Oh, wow. She was gorgeous.
Wasn't she?
I remember her being all drawn and sunken, really old.
No, she wasn't old. She was 55 when she died. No, she was just sick.
There are all kinds of things in here. Notes and letters.
Baby pictures of you and Sean.
Mom, there's 20 people downstairs. Come on.
I'm confused. I've never been confused before. I'm forgetting words that I've known my whole life. I feel my thoughts just like slipping out of my brain. Something's wrong. I need tests or you know, some kind of brain scan or something. Something's wrong.
Is there any Alzheimer's in your family?
Alzheimer's? God, no. How old do you think I am?
I know, but there's an early onset Alzheimer's. The fact that it's not very common and there's no history in your family says that's not what's going on here, but I have to ask.
No, my father died of a heart attack. My mother had cancer, you know that. Both my parents were sharp as tacks.
As are you. But I'm sure it's just stress. You're working 60 hours a week. But if you want me to send you to neurological testing, I can do that. I'll make some calls and set up an appointment. Now, let's see. What's a good time for you?
Okay. All right. I'll call you then.
Jack, still quality control at Lawton?
Yeah.
They have good insurance.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Everybody does that at some time.
Do they?
So do I have it?
The spec test says you do. It's not totally accurate, but your scores were in the 95th percentile.
Really? 95? That's the best grade I ever got. My mother would be so proud.
Do you really think that's funny?
Probably not. It's not even true. I got 95s in everything. So how long before I'm a vegetable?
I wouldn't use that word.
How about, basket case?
Do you want to tell me about how frightened you are?
Do you want to tell me what's going on in my brain?
Diane, we don't know. With Alzheimer's, you can never be sure. One of the most frustrating things about this disease is you'll never be able to know what to expect. Depressions, hallucinations, confusion. There'll be times when you won't remember how to dress yourself, how to use a knife and fork, even who you are. Right now you feel really bad because you're in a downward spiral. But there'll be times when you'll feel all right. Whole periods when everything will be normal. I noticed you came by yourself. Have you told your family about this?
No.
You might think of telling your husband.
And then again, I might not.
Why's that?
Can I go home now?
Hey, you're home early.
I went shopping.
Yeah, what for?
Dress? For the governor's thing?
Am I expected to go to that thing with you? I hate those deals, you know.
You didn't have to.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
You know, I got leave tonight.
You not going in today?
Headache.
You want an aspirin?
You use a knife and fork to eat with, don't you? Answer me.
Yeah, of course you do.
I thought so.
Do you want me to call the office and tell them you're not coming in?
No. I'll go in later.
All right. I gotta run. I'll see you tonight, okay?
Days with a bad headache.
Days?
I've been thinking, maybe it's menopause or something.
I better call the office.
Dad did that already. Did you hear what I said about menopause?
Yes, I heard.
What do you think? You've been forgetting things? You never used to get headaches before? Mom, you should call a doctor.
Okay. I'll go to a doctor.
Promise?
I promise.
Hey, You never showed me the dress you bought for the governor's party.
Oh, it's in the, in where I keep my clothes.
Wow. It's sensational.
You think? Not too much.
Except for the price.
Well, the office is paying for it.
Ah, then it's definitely not too much.
Diane, time to introduce the man himself. Oh my God. Diane McGowan actually has stage fright.
Knock him dead, Diane.
Nobody's gonna believe it.
So here's the gal I have to thank for putting together such a terrific evening. I don't suppose you're a member of my party.
What party?
Diane's not political, it's part of her charm.
Okay, let's go. Relax.
Let's hear it for Diane!
Yeah.
Yeah, Diane.
I'm sorry.
Dan? Mom?
Who is this?
So what happened?
Well, I got there and Ginny was there and Mom said she was okay, but she was really freaked out.
Did she know who you were?
Yeah, of course she knew who I was. What happened to the thing? Why did she call you in the first place?
Well, Ginny says that she like froze on stage.
Wait,
on the podium.
You mean like stage fright?
Yeah, and then she ran out. Like right through the crowd.
She just ran away?
Yeah.
Did she talk about it to you?
No, she didn't. You know, Mom, she said she was okay. She didn't want to talk about it, but she didn't talk at all.
Did you tell her you knew?
I didn't know what to say. She wouldn't talk about it. She was quiet the whole way home.
You guys haven't seen her taking any pills or anything, have you?
Give me a break. Mom's never taken anything stronger than an aspirin.
All the stress working for those lousy lawyers, now she's losing it.
Somebody doesn't just lose it overnight.
It's not overnight, damn it. She's been losing it for a long time now.
I've got Alzheimer's disease.
What you doing, Scampi?
Could be very dangerous, you know.
I was just thinking.
What, Mr. Blue?
About when I was a little kid. When we used to go to Grandma's every Sunday. Everybody. Aunts, uncles, cousins, whole family. I loved being part of a big family. We'd have dinner, and it'd get late, and my dad would drive us home. I'd curl up in the back seat, close my eyes, and I'd fall asleep. And we'd turn into that long driveway. I'd wake up and see my house with the trees all around. And I felt so safe.
You scared the hell out of me.
Sorry.
I don't know about this Alzheimer's thing, Diane. But you're really the smartest person I know. I mean, even now, you still got a real high IQ, you know. And nobody has to know about this. It's nobody's business. You know, the next time you're having a spell or something like that, you can just stay at home.
I'm going to die. In a very degrading, horrible way.
Oh, who says that?
I am. I'm gonna end up like an infant.
Come on, you're not gonna end up like an infant.
I am, Jack. And you need to know that. I need to know that you know that.
Yeah, well, that's an awful lot to take in all at once, isn't it? I mean, I'm sorry if I'm not acting the way I'm supposed to. I'm doing the best I can. You didn't even tell me in the first place.
Because you don't hear me. I don't know how many years it's been since you've heard me.
You always got to get your digs in, don't you?
Okay. I didn't tell you because I don't feel I can count on you. You're not there. And I'm scared. Because a really big thing is coming and I'm scared you're not going to be there. Are you?
You never really ever needed anybody but yourself.
Is that your answer?
Sounds like a beer.
It stinks.
Let me count the ways.
What are you going to do for money?
Oh, you know, I mean, we've got Jack's military pension and, you know, he's making enough.
Oh, bull. It's always been on your shoulders. I talked to the partners.
We've agreed to give you 6 months at full salary.
What?
We took a vote. It was unanimous.
You don't have to do that.
There's no discussion.
Thank you. I don't know what to say.
I don't know what to say either. I'm sorry, Diane. I'm just so sorry.
Okay, here we go.
You want a cup of coffee?
I've already got one.
Now don't forget, not a word about my quitting to your father.
I know, I won't. Still don't see why not, though.
Because I said so. Okay? Now just worry about the money.
Well, maybe you should start thinking about selling Grandma and Grandpa's house. It's been 5 years since Grandpa died, right?
No, I'm not gonna sell the house. Where would Grandma live?
Mom, Grandma's dead.
Your father to know. Call your brother.
Okay. What about Paula?
Paul? I don't know where Paula is.
You haven't heard from her?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. What's wrong with you?
After a coffee, we're gonna go for a walk, right?
I'm take him for a walk in a bit.
Let me have him. I'll take him for a walk.
Mom, no.
What? Oh. You never know where we'd end up.
Sorry. It's just...
I'd never do anything to hurt you.
I know that. Let's all go for a walk.
I don't want to go for a walk.
Dr. Kevorkian said he attached Adkins to a heart monitor, then put an intravenous tube in her arm. He said she was unconscious in 25 seconds and died in 5 or 6 minutes. Dedicated teacher all her life, 56-year-old Adkins was diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease a little over a year ago. However, family members insisted that she was of rational mind when she made the decision to take her life. They have made an official request to the district attorney, hoping there will be no prosecution. Detroit City Council today voted on a measure that would fund more than 15...
Have Lisa's parents said anything to you about me?
No.
No? Do you feel embarrassed? Because I know your dad does.
Why do you say that?
Oh, it's obvious. He doesn't want anyone at the plant to know. He said when I'm having one of my spells, you know, I should just stay in my room. And I'm embarrassed, you know, I feel ashamed.
Mom, I have never been ashamed of you. Not even for a minute. Even when you danced with Benji Perkins at my 12th birthday party.
I did, didn't I? Janet Jackson, Control. I was a happening girl.
You can remember that.
Oh, yeah. I just can't remember what I had for breakfast. I don't know what I'm gonna be like.
So what?
Aren't you scared? Your sister didn't even want to let me take the baby out for a walk.
Well, you know, I hit a tree at 65 miles an hour, so not a lot scares me. Are you scared? You know, I think that if you could rely on Dad a little bit more, maybe this other stuff wouldn't be so scary to you.
Dad and I do just fine. Now go to bed. Go on.
I'm not leaving while you're still scared.
Then I'm going to bed.
Okay, I'll go to bed.
Okay. You always make me feel better. Thank you.
Something for dinner tonight?
I don't care.
I'm running late. I'll see you then. Some takeout.
Tonight's low near 50.
I had a long day. I'm not very hungry.
With a high of 34. With the wind out of the north at 19 miles.
Dog.
I'm going to put you on new medication. Hopefully you'll get some relief from the most severe symptoms. This medication seems to be doing that. I've had some good results from people in your age group.
My age group? Are there a lot of people in my age group?
Not a lot.
Some people? I'd really like to talk to them.
I don't know, Diane. There are privacy issues.
Well, I'd sure be willing to give up some of my privacy to have somebody I could share this stuff with. I bet you you'd find at least some of your patients who feel the same way. This Alzheimer's thing, it's really isolating, you know? People get lonely.
Coming and meeting us here.
Oh.
He really loves this place. He never would have come to your house.
Oh, I like it here too. Is that him there?
Yes. So, should I stay?
Oh, no.
I really appreciate what you're doing, Diane. Albert needs this. Well, to be honest, I need this. Mm. So, should I come back about 3?
Oh, I don't know. Okay.
Okay. Don't let him scare you.
Hi. I'm Diane McGowan. We have the same neurologist, Dr. Newman. Your sister says you like this place.
Does she?
I really like coming here, too. I used to bring my kids here in the winter. You want to go for a walk?
It's your party.
I'll just be quiet.
Somehow I doubt that. I taught history at State University. They tell me I spoke 4 languages. Times have changed. A while ago I wandered away and was gone for 3 days.
Boy, I haven't done that yet.
Ah, but do you know that for certain? I went through a divorce, you see. My wife left me when I couldn't teach anymore. I couldn't convince her that tying my shoes was an adequate substitute for her tenure on the Arts Council.
Boy, I'm sorry.
Don't be. She was right. Who could blame her? I'm resigned to dying from this pernicious illness. I only hope my deterioration is rapid. I'm thinking of taking up smoking again, eating lots of nitrates, hasten the process.
Well, you know, we could change all that. We could spend a lot of time together. We could take walks. We could listen to music. We could start our own music society. What kind of music do you like?
17th century? Earlier? Luca Marenzio?
Oh, yeah?
When I was gone, I slept in a laundromat with my sister's dog. The dog never came home. They never found him. We seem to be in the same sinking ship.
Yeah, well, that's why I wanted Dr. Newman to introduce us. I was hoping maybe we could help each other. So is this okay with you? Can we meet sometimes? You want to be friends?
I can't promise I'll remember you.
That's okay. Then we'll start over.
Hello, Diane.
It's Albert Morelli. I wanted to call before I forget. I would like to get together again. And for our music society, I don't mind listening to something light like Alban Berg.
Yes! Berg. Let's get the ball, you ball. Get the ball, you ball. Get the ball, you ball. Get the ball, you ball.
Hi.
Hi.
Casual Friday?
Yeah, I got home early.
Yeah, the heating system broke down at work. I about froze my buns off. I thought we might go out for Chinese. I could use a little hot and spicy.
I can make dinner.
I know you can. I just thought it might be nice for a change. Just the two of us.
Okay.
Good deal. What time should I pick you up?
So now he's living with his sister and her family. He's had it a lot longer than I have. Anyway, he was diagnosed, you know, some time ago. What I was thinking was that we could all get together for dinner or something, you know? You and me and Albert and I forget her name.
But I don't see the point.
They're very interesting people.
But what would we have in common?
Hello? Anybody home?
Huh?
I'll be right back. I'm going to the ladies' room.
Are you okay?
I don't know.
Kiss me. Kiss me.
I don't know. Where were you?
I just went to get the car.
You just left me there. What'd you do that for?
I didn't leave you.
You did it on purpose.
Oh, stop.
Go, get out of here. Go on. I will just get out of here. You bastard! I don't know how to get home!
So I sent out tons of emails to all these neurologists all across the Midwest trying to convince them to start support groups, you know? And I got an answer from this one doctor in Minneapolis. He wants me to come and talk to some of his patients, just for a couple of days, but I don't know. You know, Jack can't get off work, and I don't know. You think I should go alone?
You'll go. You'll fret about it, you'll talk it to death, but you'll go. What's the worst thing that could happen?
Whoa. I could lose it completely. I could make a complete fool of myself. I could drool and fall on my face and forget who I am.
You don't drool. Even I don't drool.
How do you know? Who would tell you?
You would.
I guess I would.
Some coffee?
Oh, yeah.
Two coffees, please. My treat today.
Thank you. $40 for two coffees?
Not enough.
That's too much.
You do it. The bills all look alike to me.
Okay. I'll do the bills. And you have to do the coins. I'm no good at coins. Between the two of us, we almost make a whole person.
Thanks.
So, this is it. This is where I gave my scintillating lectures to several hundred of Michigan's finest.
It's so beautiful.
I was known for my one-on-one counsel. My students meant a great deal to me. Mind you, that was when I still had a heart.
No more?
Who's that fellow over the rainbow?
Oh, the Tin Man?
Absolutely empty in here.
The Scarecrow. Just stuffing. Nothing but stuffing. Hey, Albert, why don't you come to Minneapolis with me?
Are you out of your mind?
And that, I got Alzheimer's, remember? You could come, though. You wouldn't get lost. We can stay in the same room. You should do it. It's a chance to make a difference. Listen, if we can find the airport, we can have a swell time.
We can't go to Minneapolis that weekend because they got me on the rotation schedule.
What, you can't get 2 days off?
No, I tried. Some of the guys are still on winter vacation and that's a couple.
It's okay. I'm going with Albert.
That's ridiculous.
Why? It's just for 2 days. I think it'll be really fun for both of us.
But he's even worse off than you are, isn't he?
Well, how would you know? You've never even met him.
Because you're the one that told us all about him.
Dad, this is a lot more important than some guy's vacation. Get off the schedule and go.
You stay out of it. It's got nothing to do with you.
The doctor's arranged for the whole thing. We're going to be picked up at the airport. We'll be driven all over town. We'll be brought back to the airport. We'll be supervised the whole time like good little kids.
Mom, that's not what he meant.
Well, give me a little credit, will you?
The answer is no.
Did anyone hear me ask a question? I don't think so.
McGowan, room 502.
Oh, there isn't any number on here.
I know. It's a safety precaution. That way, if you lose it, no one knows what room it goes to.
Not even us. Would you mind just writing the number on there for me, please? And on his, too? Thank you.
I thought you said we'd stay together.
We are. But I couldn't tell her that. What are you doing?
It's going to be too difficult.
What do you mean? What are all these?
The notes for my speech tomorrow.
You're not going to give a lecture, Albert. Nobody wants you to give a speech.
You have no right to do that.
I wasn't going to read them.
Damn right.
Look, all you have to do is just speak from your heart.
I have no heart. I told you, it was the first thing to go.
Of course you have a heart. Think of your students. Think of those students you took out of that enormous classroom and helped.
Diane, I want silence.
Yes, Professor.
I'm not speaking to your little gathering tomorrow. It's just not going to happen.
One of the hardest things for me right now is that I can't communicate with my family at all, especially my husband. You know, I try to tell him what's going on with me, and he just, it's like he doesn't believe me. He doesn't hear me.
Aren't you worried about what your husband's going to do if he's going to stay with you and take care of you when you can't even pick up a spoon anymore? I mean, how's he going to do that when you can't get through to him?
We can't be sure anybody's going to do it. And my sister has been taking care of me. And she's been wonderful. But the other day, she got irritated. And she said, you told me that before. And I knew, from that moment on, she was not going to stick around.
Why doesn't he talk? Nobody has to talk.
I have a heart, Diane.
I know.
In the beginning, I was adrift. In limbo. Just nothingness. And then you. Then I came alive again. That's when it all began. When I met you.
For me, too. That's when it happened.
Yes?
Yes.
That's it. That's good. That's it.
I love what you said this afternoon.
What did I say?
You don't remember?
Not a word. Tell me.
All the right things. He said all the right things. You know, we could walk off into the sunset, but we'd never find our way back. Jack?
Hi. Oh, hi.
Hi.
You're back early.
No, I'm right on time.
And you didn't call.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, we were worried about you.
Oh.
So how'd it go?
It was wonderful. A lot of really interesting people to care about.
John's your friend, my guy.
Just fine.
I am.
He was fine.
That's crazy. Glad you went, huh?
Yeah, I'm really glad. Yeah, there's this interesting discussion. Everyone's talking about who's going to take care of them, you know, when they... later on, when they couldn't do it anymore. And so I was thinking, you know, we should talk about that. Because, you know, someone's going to have to brush my hair, and feed me, brush my teeth, wipe the drool off my chin.
Yeah.
So, who do you think's going to do that?
Well, you know, maybe we can get a part-time nurse or a medical student, somebody like that, huh?
Yeah. Well, I was thinking more, you know, about you, you know. I was thinking, are you going to be there, you know, to hold me when I forget how to breathe?
Are you laying all this on me now for? For God's sake, you just came through the door.
Well, I'd really like to know. I need to know.
But you're doing great, aren't you?
Well... you know, things are changing. I haven't been honest with you. I had to quit my job.
What?
I haven't been going to work.
Since when?
Since, a while. I don't know. I wrote it down.
Oh, now why didn't you tell me, for God's sakes? I'm not the enemy, kid.
So are you gonna take care of me?
Try. Okay? I'll try. Christ, I put the dog out and I haven't fed him all day.
It's so cold. What are you doing outside? Oh, you having a bad day? I had one yesterday. Boy, I got lost and I was home. I couldn't find my own room.
Is this going to be one of your non-stop talking days?
No. I just want to say one thing. I'm really glad we went to Minneapolis. I wanted to thank you for coming with me. You may not remember that you did, but you did, and I'm grateful. So, you want to talk about the university? The Civil War?
No. No.
No?
No. No.
You want to tell me who Alban Berg was? How about that? I remembered the name. Well, we could go for a walk. I'd love to see some trees. You want to go to the Arboretum?
You won't remember how to get there.
I do. Right now, I do.
Lucky for us,
they keep all this alive right in the middle of the city.
Lucky for us.
Did I ever tell you about my trees around the house I grew up in? Did I ever tell you about the attic I used to play in?
No, I don't know. Maybe. I don't care. I want to hear.
Oh,
I want
to
hear.
Come on. It's really important to talk to each other, especially when one of us is feeling down.
Because you always have to be the boss. You're always the boss every time.
What are you talking about?
You're the boss. You pick the music in the car. You pick everything. You pick where we go. You pick the days. I don't like Elvis Presley. I like,
Who do you like? Tell me. Tell me all the names. Tell me all the names of all the great composers. If you're so much better than I am.
Shut up! Bossy! Mahler! I like Mahler! Diane, come back!
Thank you.
going? I was hoping maybe I could take him for a walk or something.
He's not doing very well.
Really? Can I come in for a minute? We usually manage to cheer each other up.
No, Diane. He's not at home anymore.
Where is he?
He had a severe episode, and we had to put him
in a hospital?
A facility.
You took him away?
It's a very good care facility.
No, we don't need that. He can just come right out of it.
No, Diane, he's not going to come out of it. He had absolutely no idea who I was.
Just one day. You know, tomorrow he could be just fine. Listen, Miss, what's your name?
Linda.
Linda, maybe if you can't take care of him anymore, he could come and live at my house with me. He's better with me.
No, that's not possible.
Why not? Don't you love him?
Of course I love him. You knew this was going to happen. We knew it would happen. We just didn't know when. I've done the best I could. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry about your friend.
Albert. His name is Albert.
No. Now, you'll meet other people. It's not the end of the world.
It's the end of my world. Albert's gone, and I'm right behind him. I'm losing a little more of myself every day. Pretty soon, I won't even exist.
Come on, don't talk like that. I'll ask Sean to check in on you later, all right?
No, don't ask him. Don't ask him anything.
Yeah, I could take care of it. Just make sure I got all the paperwork, okay?
Who is that?
I gotta go now. So I'll see you later. Bye-bye. That was the night shift foreman. I had to check in.
Liar.
I'm not lying.
It was Paula, wasn't it?
What?
I know you've been talking to Paula.
Sure, I told you I was talking to her about finding someone to come in a couple of times a week and help out around here. Keep an eye on things.
Things? Keep an eye on things?
Stop it, Diane. This ain't funny.
I know the plan.
What plan?
You and Paula.
Oh, boy.
You're planning to put me in a facility, aren't you?
I don't know what you're talking about.
A facility! Before I get to be a problem for you.
Don't be ridiculous.
Because I can tell you right now, I'm not going.
And I can tell you that nobody is going to force you to go anywhere, sweetheart. But I got to go to work now.
Sure you do. You're such a liar.
Please.
I'm on to you.
I can't take the fighting anymore.
You're such a liar. You're not going to work.
Well, this is the truth. I'm out of here.
Liar! I don't know you, lady. Get out of my house!
Trace, it's Dad. Yeah, I just got in. Look, Mom's car's not here. Is she over there? No. Yeah, that's all right. Yeah, you're right. She probably told me and I forgot. All right, thanks, love. Bye-bye.
I called Albert's house, but his sister told me they hadn't seen or heard from her since yesterday. Now, do you know if Diane had a key to her office? Well, I didn't think so. No, Jenny didn't know either. I called the police. They won't touch it. It's too early. I say it's too soon. Yeah. No, it's all right. Yeah, I will when I hear. Thank you, Paula.
Like the wind. There goes Diane, they used to say. She's gonna crack her head open. This girl, she was fearless and loud. She had a big mouth even then. I led all of the sit-ins. You hear that, Albert? I never was the silent type.
Yeah. Hey, Scappy, how you doing, kid? There you are. Come on, it's been a while. Come on, I'll help you down.
No.
It's me, Jack. Don't be afraid.
I'm not afraid. I've been here a long time. Maybe a week.
No. Just overnight.
Really?
Just one night, but I missed you like it was a week. Come on. Let's go home, kid.
You can't just try. It's not enough.
I know. I'm going to take care of you. Whatever happens, I'll be there for you, I promise. Hey, come on. You gotta trust me, see? Because I heard you. And now I know what you meant about being safe.
You did. You heard me.
Uh-huh.
I'm not gonna lose myself. I remembered who I am. Now, whatever happens to my mind or my body, who I am isn't gonna go away. I'm not gonna disappear. Still Diane. Diane with Alzheimer's, but Diane.
Never forget you and what you meant in my life. And even when you don't know me, I'll know you. I promise.
Now, you'll get what you asked for.
I'm gonna get to the bottom of this.
Lifetime Movie Network's Pick a Flick Fridays. What movie came out on top?
Oh, now look at this.
Watch tonight at 8 to find out.
You do this every day?
I'm very, very selective.
It's just a click to pick your flick. Lifetime Movie Network's Pick a Flick Fridays. Tonight at 8, only on Lifetime Movie Network.